So we've talked about the turning radius, and that's an important factor in a coordinated turn. But there's also some other important things, and one of those is the maximum turning rate, or we'll just talk about the turning rate in general before we figure out what the maximum turning rate is. So let's go back to our free body diagram, which I have already drawn here. And I'm going to draw the forces on here once again. This will be kind of just a review for everyone here. So we have the lift here. Here is the weight. But remember, because we're using projections, because this is a front view, this is the lift, but this is the weight times cosine gamma. This is phi. And then let's go to the other views here. So we have our thrust, drag, weight, lift. And this is our climb angle gamma. This is L cos phi because we are at a bank angle. Thrust, drag, or just as they are, and this is the weight. Okay, and then finally, on our figure down here, we have our turning, or we have our, yes, our turning radius. Here we have V cos gamma, which is our tangential velocity. And then we're going to label one force on here, and that is pointing inward, and that is L sine gamma. Okay, so let's review some of our equations here. So from our force balance, we had that L sine gamma, sine phi is W over G V cos gamma squared divided by R. We also had that L cos phi equals W cos gamma. And so with these two equations, we can do something kind of interesting. And that's to solve for R a different way than what we did before. And there'll be a reason for this, but we're going to just go ahead and start it. So the first thing that we do is we square both of these equations, and then we add them together. What that gives us is L squared sine squared phi plus cos squared phi. And I promise there's some method to this madness, and it will become apparent in just a little bit. And that's going to be equal to, now we add these two together, so we have W V squared cos squared gamma divided by GR all squared plus W squared cos squared gamma. So this is an identity that sine squared phi plus cos squared phi is equal to 1. Okay, so we can rewrite this, simplify it out, as L squared equals WV squared cos squared gamma divided by GR all squared plus W squared cos squared gamma. And now we can solve for R, and I'm not going to go through all the details of this. I encourage you to do it on your own, but it's just algebra. Solving for R gives us R equals WV squared cos squared gamma divided by G times square root of L squared plus W squared cos squared gamma. And we can simplify this by bringing this W down into the square root, and that simplifies then to be V squared cos squared gamma divided by G times root L over W L, that, excuse me, that's L squared over W squared plus cos squared gamma. Okay, so now that we have that, let's recall that our load factor, N, is equal to L over W. So if we use that and plug it in, then let's see, we're going to plug that right into here. Then what we find is that R equals V squared cos squared gamma divided by G root N squared minus cos squared gamma. Okay, so from here, let's make the assumption. So from here, we're going to say, actually, that'll be confusing if I say it that way. Let's do this. So assume that gamma is small. So if we assume that gamma is small, and by small I mean approximately zero, then this equation simplifies to be R equals V squared over G root N squared minus 1. Okay, let's star that. Okay, so right now it might look like I'm just kind of playing with equations to get something fun. But there's going to be a good reason that we want to have this expression later on. Okay? All right, so from here, let's talk about the turning rate. That's what we came here for, right? So I'm going to go to green. So turning rate. And sorry, I must apologize. You've probably noticed I go back and forth between all caps, lowercase, cursive. It's all the same to me. So I hope that my reading is legible for you. Okay, so the turning rate is just the angular velocity of our turn. So we're going to call it omega, capital omega. Okay? Now, because it's an angular velocity, we can use an expression that we know. So let's recall, this is something that you should have learned already. So recall that angular velocity is just tangential velocity divided by r. Okay, we know the tangential velocity, so let's go back up to our figure. Tangential velocity is v cos gamma, and we have r there. Okay, so let's write this out. In that case, omega is going to be v cos gamma divided by r. Now, let's assume that the climb angle is small, so this comes out to be approximately V over R. And now we have an equation for R, and it has a V squared in it, so if we do V over R, what we'll come up with is, just by plugging that in, will be G root N squared minus 1 divided by V. Okay, and this is phi star. Okay, where star is shown here. Okay, so now we need to decide what to do with this load factor. Okay, so our stall limited load factor is what we'll use here for the turning rate. Okay, so recall that the stall limited load factor N max is equal to 1/2 rho V squared divided by W over SW times CL max. Okay, if we plug that in to our equation here, then what we'll get is the maximum turning rate. That's that we can get before we stall. So I guess the stall limited maximum turning rate is what we'll call it. So that's going to be G times square root of this guy. I'm going to bring the 2 down. So we have rho V squared over 2W over SW times CL max times V squared, because we have this V here. So it's kind of funny, we're now under the square root, so we have this V squared that comes in. It's going to be minus 1 over V squared. If you're not sure how I got there, I encourage you to just plug this in and try it out. Okay. All right, so that is the stall limited maximum turning rate. We can also find a turning rate that's limited by the structure, where if we try to turn faster, we will enter structural failure. So I'm going to go to yellow, and we're going to say that the positive load limit is N max equals NPLL times W max over W. Okay, so if we plug that in now, so now we're going to come back up into this equation here, then what we get is omega max, and we're going to call this the load limited maximum turning rate, is going to be G divided by V times root NPLL W max over W quantity squared minus 1. Great. Okay, so that is another maximum turning rate that we can get. Okay, but as we've talked about before, I'm going to just review this real quick. Let's say we have, let's say we have a VN diagram, and it looks something like this. Sorry, I'm freehanding this, so it's maybe not as pretty as it could be, but it looks something like this, okay? Well, there's a point here that we know, or that we want to know, which is the maneuver point, okay? We've defined maximum turning rate that's limited by stall and a maximum turning rate that's limited by the load factor. And so it might be interesting for us to know then what's the maximum turning rate that we can get at the maneuver point. And it turns out that this omega max at the maneuver point is the maximum turning rate that we can get overall. We can't go any higher than that. And the way that we find it is by plugging in our maneuver velocity into either equation, either the turning rate stall limited or the maximum load limited turning rate. Okay, so let's just write down as a review, our maneuver velocity is the square root of 2 NPLL divided by CL max. Oh man. CL max times the square root of W over SW divided by rho. So if we plug this guy, say, into here, You can do either one. It doesn't really matter. What you're going to find is that omega max, this is the maximum possible turning rate, is equal to the square root of CL max divided by 2 times NPLL times W max divided by W minus W over NPLL W max. Sorry, that went a little too far. So that's all under the square root. And then we multiply this by G times the square root of rho over W over SW. And there you have it, your maximum turning rate. So just as a review, we found this maximum turning rate, this final answer here, by finding the maximum allowable turning rate that's stall limited and the maximum load limited turning rate, and then plugging in the maneuver velocity into either one of those equations, and that gave us our maximum turning rate.